way now. And I'm finishing, sorry, somebody had a birthday party here. I'm finishing a night patrol. And I just wanted to pull over, literally smack in the middle of the wheat and barley fields of Ruth and Boaz, and just kind of trade one armor for the next. So here, we're gonna stop this beast right here, right now. Let me show you where I am. It's just gorgeous, as we say. It's amazing out here. It's, again, one of my most favorite places to come to. Boker Tov, Richard. Y'all can see the sun rising over Bethlehem. You could just make out the buildings of Bethlehem right over this hill, where I am, like right there in the middle. So the focus isn't necessarily Bethlehem today. The focus is just to have a beautiful spot to park us in the wheat fields right here, because we have a holiday coming up where we are going to be reading the book of Ruth. And these are the very fields where Boaz first saw Ruth. And I think it's a gorgeous place just to sit and pray together. And if you'd like to join me, join me. If you wouldn't like to join me, go to sleep or have a wonderful night. God bless you all. So, just bear with me for a second. And what we're going to do is we're going to put on our tallit. That's the big white prayer shawl you see men wearing when they pray. And we're going to put on our tefillin, which is what's in English called phylacteries. Horrible word. But these are not just traditions. These aren't just quaint customs. These are commandments from God that are going to be directly related to the hero Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one prayer that we're about to recite together. That dates back to the entire nation of Israel and the world receiving the Torah on the mountain of Sinai. So, make sure I still have you guys. See if anybody's joining. That's awesome. And let me just get you a slightly different view here. Great. It's more beautiful than you can imagine. I'm just gonna trade this armor for this armor. Now, I'm going to be turning my back to you, and I'm going to be facing Jerusalem, which for Jews all over the world, it's facing east, but for us right here, we face a little bit north to hit Jerusalem, and I'm going to put on my tallit, and I'm going to say the blessing over it. Now, if you're just tuning in, I don't know if you've ever prayed overlooking Bethlehem and Jerusalem at sunrise, but even if you've done it 100 times, the 101st is just as glorious as the 99th and the 100th. You don't even have to see Bethlehem or Jerusalem, because I'm not praying to a city. I'm not praying to a field. I'm not praying to the sun. I'm praying to God. And that's in every corner, in every closet, in every trench, in every field throughout the world. It doesn't matter where you are. As Solomon said, one day you're going to be led out of your land. The temple is going to be destroyed. You're not going to have a temple to pray or bring your sacrifices to necessarily. What you're going to do is you're going to face Jerusalem and you're going to pray to God. And through sincere prayer and repentance, God will forgive your sins. That was written by Solomon, and that still applies today. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam. Asher kiddushanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu lahaniach tefillin. Now, I'm not going to keep you guys for too long. I just want to take you about as close as I can to get to Bethlehem, and then we can say the Shema prayer together. Okay? So, let's just walk over a little bit. Sorry about that. I'm just getting organized. All right, we're just going to step over here for a second. Just take another minute. Really, it's a beautiful morning here. I can just show you how gorgeous it is here every day. It's kind of cool to get to walk through the fields overlooking Bethlehem with me at any time, at the touch of a button. I just wish you were here, you were able to do it with me. If you are coming to Israel, please check out the Unity Warriors experience. It's a beautiful time in these very fields. Okay, so from this spot, we're going to stand together wherever you are in the world. If you're even laying in bed, you don't have to stand up. You could just be apart. You could stare at Bethlehem if you'd like. You can stare at Jerusalem over that beautiful fig tree that is so magnificent and going to be so filled with fruit soon. Let's pray together. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Shema Yisrael Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad. V'yahavta et Adonai Elohecha b'chol levavcha b'chol nafshecha u'b'chol me'odecha. V'ayu ha'davarim ha'ele asher anochi mitzavcho hayom al levavecho v'shinantam levanecha v'dibar tabam v'shiftecha b'beitecha u'v'lechtecha b'derech u'v'shachvecha u'v'kumecha u'kshartam la'ot ayedecha v'ayu l'totofot ben einecha u'chtavtam al mezuzot beitecha u'v'sharecha v'aya im shamoa tishma'u אל מצוותיי אשר אנוכי מצווה אתכם היום להבוא את אדוני אלוהיכם ולעבדו בכל לבבכם ובכל נפשכם ונתתם את ארצכם ביתו ירא ומקוש ויספת עוד דגונך ותירושך ויצורך ונתתי עשה ושדך לבמתך ויחלת וספותו הישמרו לכם פן יפתה לבבכם ושרתם לבדתם אלוהים אחרים ושתחוויתם להם וחרא אף אדוני בכם ביצרת השמיים ולא יהיה מטר ואדמה לא תיתן את טיבולו עבדתם מהירה מעל הארץ הטובה אשר אדוני נותן לכם ושמתם את דברי אלה על לבבכם מהנפשכם וקשרתם אותם לאות עידכם והיו לטוטפות בין עיניכם לימדתם אותם את בניכם לדבר בם ושפתך בביתך ובלכתך בדרך ובשכבך ובקמך למען ירבו ימיכם ימי בניכם על האדמה אשר נשבע אדוני לאבותיכם לתת להם כימי השמיים
al haaretz. Vayomer Adonai el Moshe lemor. Daber el bnei Yisroel v'yemarta aleihem. V'yasu lehem tzitzit al kanfei digdehem ledaratam. להיות לכם לאלוהים, אני אדוני, אלוהיכם אמת.
Now, that's not even a fraction of the morning prayers. That's just one of the main aspects of our absolute testament of truth, not just faith, of truth in God's oneness, in God's eternal covenant, in God's Torah. Those aren't my words, those are words that were inscribed in the Holy Torah, in the Holy Tongue, by the Creator of all. And these are words that the Jewish people have been saying every single day ever since. Pretty amazing, if you ask me, that we can all be a part of it overlooking Bethlehem and Jerusalem at a gorgeous sunrise. Thank you all for being with me right now. I'm going to go finish my prayers. Not by myself, because right now I know that there's hundreds of people that have just been inspired to pray, to love, to feel, and to look at Israel and say, God bless Israel in all its glory, because it is so glorious. So glorious. Anyways, you guys have a beautiful day, and thank you so much for standing with us in Israel, no matter who you are, no matter if you're Jewish or not. It just don't matter, as we say. We all need to stand up under the roof of Israel, arm in arm, hand in hand, shoulder to shoulder, in unity, bypassing political boundaries, racial boundaries, everything, in order so that we can all march forward and just quite literally follow this light so we can rebuild Jerusalem. B'mheirah v'yamenu. Amen.